It's wonderful to have you back with us in Leicester Square this morning. Are you excited for another kids' film, another big one?
I've got about 200 children with me. Well, I feel like it's 200, but I think I've got about 8 with me. So they've all run through with excitement.
I think obviously this is a film that celebrates the imagination of childhood. I'm curious, when you were a little girl yourself, did you have worlds or characters that you liked to escape with when you were having playtime?
Well, yeah, I mean, I've got lots of favourites, obviously, but I'm all for like imagination, and I hate, kids being stuck to like games on the thing. So I'm like, they've got every character in dressing up stuff and, tea parties. I remember being a little girl and spending hours in the garden having dolls party tea parties. And I'd have all the china around me and all the dolls around me. It's about, that's about childhood playing, which I think is, we have to all embrace that. I'm an older mum, so I had children in my 20s. 30s and 40s. So I've seen the difference about playing and the freedom that children can't so much have these days as they used to. But I promote playing to the utmost. So no television, all day, no games all day, and country walks and parks and going through mum's dressing up stuff. And, so yes, I'm all for adventure and imagination. I don't know whether you're aware, but I'm a foster carer as well. So I've been doing that 27 years. So although I've got 4 birth children, I've fostered over 250 children. And I've seen such a difference in the way that children are. And I think I'm totally, everything in moderation. But I agree with you. I think sometimes it's easy just to like leave the kids to their own devices. But, go out, I promote this, go out of the garden, make a tent, throw everything in the tent, make a mess. At the end of the day, you can talk about it. It's about writing about what you've done. It's about exploring literacy skills with children. All things that I feel that really have been lost. So, I'm a great promoter to all mothers. Please help your children stretch their imagination.
On the subject of fostering, obviously, it's an amazing thing that you've done. Can you talk, I guess, just for particularly younger people about why they should consider fostering? Because it's not something I think necessarily young couples immediately think about at that point in their lives, but I think it's something that we need people to think about.
Yeah, I mean, I have so many private messages about fostering. I mean, like literally I could scroll through them all day, and I say to everybody, anyone really can foster, don't exclude yourself. So you can be a younger mother, you can be an older mother. There's lots of older mothers that have had their careers and their careers are over, whether they be like a teachers or doctors or worked in the NHS, and then all of a sudden they've retired and think, oh, this is good, but what now? What fulfillment will I get now? So younger mothers, older mothers, same-sex couples, single dads, single mums, anybody can foster. Really, the only major clause you have to have is space. So you have to have a spare bedroom and time, because obviously you can't foster if you're leaving the house at 7 in the morning and coming home at 7 at night. Because basically most children want love, stability, security. Well, all children, not most children. And they need you to be there for them. And if it's like you put everything down and sit on the floor and play for 2 hours, that's just time. Money can't buy that. But the most precious thing you can give to a child is time.